But the thing that's interesting is the way that we adapt and evolve to these things. Because, like, for example, if anyone, as you mentioned, can go say, hey, I'd like to see a movie X, like I'd like to see a J.J. Abrams film that's actually, in fact, a rom-com that involves, you know, an AI and, you know, kind of two dolphins, you know, and you know, I can get one of those. Yes, right. And so, but
and that's why we need JJ.
Yes, exactly.
That's not a
exactly.
good idea for a movie. That,
you stole my punchline, which is, you know, is that part of the thing about this is it still is like we are going to be empowered by these tools, and there's still I think going to be and I heard your earlier point about tools like. It's a partner. It's a co-creator. It's a bunch of things, but I think there's still a way that that we will bring elements that we care about as human beings. That was part of the chess point that I think Kev was making. There's still an element there for doing it, and even in the training and making of these things, they require fairly in-depth human feedback to align them to the kinds of things that we want to see, and so. I agree about the transformation, but I don't agree that we become the passive couch sitters.